it, I get it, I get it, I get it. Some things don't work and that's the way love goes. I get it, I get it, I get it, I get it. It's over now, but time will tell. I just want to say, first and foremost, thank you all for coming out in the rain, in the traffic, during the holiday time. You guys are fabulous. And for that, you shall be rewarded. Not all of you, just some of you. Just want to make that clear. I'm your host this evening, Christian Ross, and I am very, you're so kind. Oh, live stream. Here I go. Yeah. Right there. I'm your host this evening, Christian Ross. Thank you so much for coming. This is Atlanta Startup Village. Welcome! Hi, Brandon. So, how many first-timers here? Can we get a hand? Wow! Super welcome! Okay, so right now we are here, we are housed in Atlanta Tech Village, which is the fourth largest tech hub in the United States. So thank you so much for coming here. They are our perpetual sponsor, and we're so thankful. So we do have some special guests. I don't know if they want to be named, so I'm going to ask them first and announce them later, if so. But we're so excited because we showcase the innovation that's coming out of our city right here that you will see on this stage. And tonight, you'll hear from companies offering solutions that you need to know about. But we can't do this without our sponsors. So, without further ado, can I please have Greenberg Traurig come to the stage?
Yeah, we good? No. Yeah, but it, I mean, it's, I don't know, it, we don't have to. Anyway, thank you for having us. We're with, as I mentioned, we're with Greenberg Traurig. We're a global law firm, but we're, you know, we have a huge presence here in Atlanta. We're right around the corner at the Terminus building, and we've been working with Tech Village over the past year and sort of meeting folks and sponsoring events. It's been a really great experience.
Working on it. To come out and play.
Yep.
So, since there's so many newcomers tonight, let me tell you how this works. There's five companies that will come onto the stage tonight that will share with you exactly what their company is doing. They will present for 5 minutes. You will have 5 minutes for questions and answers. Those questions and answers come from you, and it makes them better for their business. So please, ask away. And at the end, you vote for the winning person who will go to our pitch-off this spring. And they'll have a chance to win 2 hot desks and parking right here at Atlanta Tech Village, a $13,000 value. Right back to you, Greenberg
Traurig. Say it. No, it's tough. It's a lot of R's in there. All right. Anyway, so like I said, we're a global law firm. We have 43 offices, but right here in Atlanta, we have over 100 attorneys that do everything from corporate work, including company formations, funding rounds, M&A, to we have a great products liability litigation department. We have an employment law division. We have entertainment lawyers who work with IP creators and with some of the greatest celebrities and stars to sort of develop their own IP portfolios. We have a finance group that Zach here is a part of. So we're full service, but we're. We're global, but we're also very deeply rooted here in Atlanta. Here in Atlanta, like I said, we do a full suite of the types of things that companies, from when you start to as you're growing to your exit, that the kind of legal services that you might need. And we do it across industry. So we're industry agnostic. We have deep biotech, entertainment, financial services, healthcare, video games, which is a group that Caitlin and I work with, fintech, life sciences, manufacturing, real estate, we do it all. And so our emerging technologies group is kind of our umbrella group for emerging company work. And we take all the different pieces, we put it together. So if you have a need, if you're with a company, if you're an investor and you're looking for anybody to work with and or just to talk with about ideas, like come and let us know. We'll be here all night, and so we'd love to talk with you. And I should also, sorry, I was remiss, I should introduce, this is Caitlin Gilbert. She works in the corporate department. Zach Branson's in our finance group, and I'm Will Grossenbacher, and we're all at Greenberg Traurig. So thank you.
Traurig. 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 So our next sponsor, I've seen him all around, and now, where is he? Carlos from Puzzle. There he is. I was like, ¿dónde está Carlos? All right, I have a giveaway. Who came here from the furthest away? Oh, okay, where'd you come from? New York. No? You said California? Oh, okay, well, but New York beat you. Los Angeles. Oh, Seattle. Okay, you guys do the geography and tell me who wins. Chicago. So wait a minute, does that mean Seattle won? Oh, you said Toronto. I'm sorry, and I know you. I'm so sorry. There you go. Toronto. There you go. That's a great shirt too. That says put your dent in the universe. Limited edition. All right, Carlos, here you go.
Hello, everyone. All right, so today we also have some extra prizes. We want to celebrate with everyone that our startup community has grown during 2022. And I think that is something that I need to be on the video. But that is something that we can all celebrate. And as part of it, we got some good puzzle swag here. And we have some simple questions for the so you can get to win one, okay? It's really easy, trust me. Okay, so the first question, and it's just a quick answer for everyone. Can you tell me what outsourcing means? Just raise your hand. We got her.
When you give a work out to another party or individual to complete it on your behalf?
Absolutely. So, see, it was really easy. Wow. But really good answer, by the way. It's like Wikipedia answer. All right. We got another one. And we've all been familiar with the concept of offshoring. Now, let's talk about nearshore. Can you tell me what's the difference between offshore and nearshore? You got it. Nice, well done. These guys came prepared today.
Thanks, boss.
Thank you. All right, so while we celebrate 2022 has been great, we also have to get ready for 2023 so we can keep growing our community and we can keep growing our businesses. Now, Puzzle wants to be part of that growth. How do we do it? It's pretty simple. We connect top companies with top talent across Latin America, and we've been, what's up? Okay. And we also been increasing our headcount in some Eastern European locations. Now, how do we do that and ensure that everyone keeps having the success that they are aiming for whenever you hire new talent? So it's pretty simple. Think about your computer. With no connection, it still works though, but it doesn't have the capabilities that you're looking for. Well, when you get connected to a global market, you get more possibilities. So that's what Puzzle does. We connect your startup with a global market of talent with a strong focus in Latin America. So it's not just about hiring new talent, but also maintaining that talent and making sure that within our ecosystem, you all succeed, both the company and the employee. So we ensure that we just don't help you finding that talent, but we give you contracts, benefits, and everything so you can have an outsourced international talent without worrying about all those unnecessary paperwork. So how we offer different three services. The first one is our CTO Plus service. If you are a non-tech founder, you have probably already struggled with trying to find an outsourced partner that really understands English and not just technology. And just trying to, as a non-tech founder, I can tell you, sometimes trying to understand technology can be really complex. So we got our CTO that will help you build your idea from the end to the beginning so we can create your solution and take it to the market. The other option is we have nearshore staffing, which if you're a tech founder and you don't need anyone to tell you how technology works, then you just need full-time developers that will be working for you and will be happy to support with that service as well. And we also got direct hire, which are the placements. If you're looking for local talent, you don't have the time to hire or just marketing is really expensive, we got you. And for all the startups that are joining us today, we got a special discount, which instead of charging the regular 20%, we're giving a 15% rate. So we got this for you. Now, I also want to thank that we've been trusted by multiple startups in the community. Proud that we are supporting a lot of ATV companies, and we are a proud villager too. So it's been a lot of support to these companies, helping them their growth, different stage, different services. How can you connect with Puzzle? Pretty simple. You come to our website, puzzle.tech, or hello@puzzle.tech. You can also find us on LinkedIn. Guess what? Ask Puzzle. And then, if you're part of the village, I'm usually hanging around on the second floor. If you want to chat or talk about how you can create your hiring strategy, 100% open to a coffee or beer. And thank you, guys.
You're so funny.
Thank you, Carlos.
This is yours.
That's not mine.
Yours?
All right. So what you came for, to see the innovation here in Atlanta this evening. Everyone, raise your hands, put them together for Ask Me Your MD. All right, good evening, Atlanta Tech Village. I am Dr. Patricia Kelly Marsh, CEO and co-founder of Ask Me Your MD, where we're giving you 24/7 access to text with a licensed physician like myself directly from your cell phone. How cool is that? So imagine with me that you receive a report from your doctor, and there are words on that report that you did not even know was in the English language. How many of you have experienced something like this? And you don't know what to do, but you know that there's a problem, and you know that you have to do something. So you try and call your doctor and see, what's up? What does this mean? But guess what? 97% of you cannot contact your doctor, unfortunately. That can leave you with some messed up stuff. You're confused, right? And God forbid it's your mom's report and you're trying to help your loved one go through a medical issue. And then you're on the phone. I've waited over 45 minutes on the patient side. I know those back end numbers. But listen, I'll tell you how to get access. And then if you make certain decisions, you're going to be paying anywhere from 4 to 6 figures. And for some patients, that includes poor health outcomes, death being one of them, unfortunately. And we've heard this time and time again. And that's why we created Ask Me Your MD, literally named like the service that we give. We give you instant access to licensed providers. We lower those medical costs by telling you the most efficient way to go about your medical problem. And we help you to understand what's going on so that you get your power back and say, I decide what happens with my body and my health. So, in short, we educate you by answering your questions. We advocate for you to make sure you're getting the care that you need, right? And then we navigate you through this crazy healthcare system. A lot of you are signing up for healthcare insurance right now. It's very difficult sometimes. And most of all, we help coordinate your care. So we will call your doctor on your behalf to bypass those long wait times. Now, we got some competitors out there. You can text with your doctor with Summer Health, but they're only pediatrics. You guys are adults. Some of you may have kids. Some of you may have ailments that require a specialist. So we provide all of the specialties in the hospital and outside of the hospital. And we're doctors, so we have that insider knowledge as to what you need to do. And we're easy to access. AskMeYourMD.com. You don't need to download an app. We're right on the website, and we're on your schedule 24/7. So this is what it looks like on your cell phone when you're talking to us. And you may ask, well, how can I get your services? I'm glad you asked. It's $150 a month for a patient subscription, or you could pay as you go. And shortly, you'll be able to pay with your insurance. You can already use your flex spending account, your health savings account. And if you're in a hospital that's contracted with us, you actually receive our services with free. And you get our services 30 days after you leave the hospital. We're gaining some traction. We got a meeting with Microsoft tomorrow. Whoop, whoop. And we have another hospital that is signed up to meet with us, also a part of the Adventist Health System in California. So the team is myself, Dr. Mission. We went to residency together out in LA. And we both have a love for educating patients. And we have a couple of asks of you. Subscribe to us. Gift our services to a loved one. Tell somebody about us. If you're an investor, invest in us. Contact at AskMeYourMD.com. And everybody take out your phones right now. Go to Instagram. at Ask Me Your MD and follow us, where we're giving you tips and knowledge for free. And how many of you, just in time for the holidays, we made these nice QR codes that go straight to our chat so that you can try our platform for free. So you can get that on your way out. Thank you.
It is time for questions.
Yes.
Who has a question in the audience? In the back?
So what is the wait time for chat? So our platform actually averages our monthly and weekly response time. Tell me, how much do you think it is? 15 seconds. My man. Try it right now. Go on AskMeYourMD.com. And Dr. Mission is on call right now. She'll answer you in less than that. Yes, sir. We are global. So right now we're talking to the Georgia Commerce, Department of Economic Commerce, in order to expand in China. And then from there, we'll go to the islands and India. So yeah, we have a global mission. Yes, sir. So we do not use Zoom, but yes, you can exchange the chat for a video or audio call. We send you the link, you let us know, because the elderly, especially those in the hospital, they don't have time to be typing with their thumbs, like they got arthritis, you know. So we made it easy for them to communicate with us. And if you are the caretaker of that person that's in the hospital, guess what? You can talk to us for free as well. I saw a hand right here.
What do you do about, how do you handle PHI and compliance?
So we are a telemedicine platform. Oh, I have to repeat the question. What do we do about HIPAA? HIPAA, you guys, is making sure that your health information is protected. And that is a legal requirement as physicians. And so our platform is HIPAA compliant. Yes, that's the short answer. Yes. Yes, sir. What are the top three KPIs for the success of our company? Number one, we want to make a difference. So we are monitoring the health outcomes of the patients that we service. And the way that we do that is we get feedback from you as the customer. Number two, our second KPI as a business is revenue. So we are looking at the revenue that we generate and the cost saved for our clients. So our enterprise client like Microsoft, any clinics that utilize our services, when we are able to defer their patients from calling 911 or from going into their office and trying something over the counter, meaning you don't need a prescription for it. And then our third KPI, we are really trying to expand. So we're looking literally at the number of contracts that we are doing. In our first region is in California and then here, because that's where we're dual licensed. Yeah, thank you. Why wouldn't another healthcare system do what we're doing? As you know, throughout the pandemic, we went through physician burnout, we went through shortages, we have so many issues with servicing the population of America, and we don't have enough doctors. You already have issues trying to contact your doctor. I'm sure you've experienced this. So they do not have the staff to have dedicated 24/7 access to a doctor to answer your question. They just don't. And so that's why we created the service, because it is a new way to practice medicine, and it is a way that we can lower your costs and make it more efficient for you and your lifestyle on your schedule. Yes, sir.
So this is asynchronous, correct? It is the same model in which you would find for any chat bot service. Repeat the question. I'm sorry. Can you repeat the question? Because I'm thinking about the answer. Right. Okay, so this is the last question, sorry. But come find me afterwards, I'll answer the questions. But the question again was, how do we scale shortly? So again, it's not that I am doing one answer at once as a physician. My knowledge base is able to answer multiple people's questions at the same time, simultaneously. So we have the volume based off of our analytics. We make sure that the demand meets the physician that are staffed on that day. And so that's how we are able to scale. So we just bring in our physicians as needed based off of the volume of demand on our platform.
Let's give it up for Ask Me, your MD. She even has a chant, y'all. She didn't do it today.
Oh, yeah, yeah. I'll sing it next time.
So coming up right now, we have Jex Rideshare Rentals. Let's give a hand clap.
Good evening. I'm Julius Bryant, co-founder and CEO of Jax. We're a car rental marketplace helping to remove vehicle access as a barrier of entry to gig work. Quick look at our traction to date. So we've done more than 20,000 unique rental days, more than $90,000 in monthly revenue currently, and most importantly, we've been able to create more than 400 jobs for prospective gig workers. I want to introduce you to Jada. Jada's a 34-year-old mother of two who recently relocated to Atlanta for a fresh start. She doesn't own a car, and she spends about 30 minutes on a bus each way to and from her part-time job, where she just barely makes enough money to support her and her two kids. She'd like to drive for Uber or Lyft to make some extra money, but because she doesn't have a car, she doesn't have that option. To address this opportunity for people like Jada, Jax has created a car rental marketplace connecting rideshare and delivery drivers that don't have access to vehicles to fleet owners like dealerships that have idle or underutilized vehicle inventory. It's a quick bottoms-up look at the market opportunity for Jax. So in America alone, there are about 2.7 million gig workers across the largest rideshare and delivery platforms. About 15% or 400,000 of them are using vehicles that they don't own to do their jobs. 85% utilization rate and about a $59 per day rental rate. That brings us to a $7.3 billion market opportunity, and that same market is projected to be over $12 billion by the year 2030. The model's simple. We're a marketplace, so fleet owners can list their vehicle inventory on the Jax platform. Renters can browse and book the vehicles on the Jax platform, pick up the vehicle from the owner, ultimately add it to their ride-share and gig accounts, and use that vehicle to start earning income. Jax takes anywhere from 30 to 40% of the rental revenue, with the remainder going directly to the owner of the vehicle. We've quickly risen to be one of the preferred gig rental solutions in the market for a number of reasons, which I had listed here. I'll just talk about one of them quickly. We're platform agnostic. So different from some of our competitors, our drivers can rent our vehicles and use them for any platform. And ultimately, that results in more earnings for the driver. If there's a bonus or incentive on one platform, they can shut off the other platform and go earn on the other one and ultimately earn more income. And our renters really love our platform. There's material benefit created in their lives through the Jax platform. 96% of our renters surveyed said they're making more money now, even after paying the rent for the vehicle, than they were making previous to renting from Jax. And they're also saving about 5 hours per week that they used to spend riding public transit. Quick look at our revenue. So we're able to double our revenue between 2020 and 2021. This little thing called the pandemic happened. There was a vehicle shortage because of the microchips So that we felt that inevitably, but we were still able to do $1.1 million in revenue this year, projecting 6.4 for next year. CAC is really low, just $4, lifetime value at over 1,300, and then average rental period is more than 60 days. Quick look at our team. So myself and my co-founder, as well as our employees, we've spent a lot of time working in technology and mobility at companies like Amazon, Hertz, GetAround, and Lyft. Co-founder has also exited another company previous to starting Jax. And then we recently brought on Adam Carley as our first advisor. He's a co-founder at Clutch, which is a vehicle subscription platform that was purchased by Cox Automotive. So the big vision is, this is really twofold. The first thing is no driver left behind. So no matter where you are in the country, whether you own a vehicle or not, everyone should be able to participate in the gig economy if they like to. That's the first piece. And the second piece is eliminating vehicle waste. There are parking lots all around America that have vehicles that are just sitting, doing nothing, that ultimately could be used to earn income through gig work. So quick look at our roadmap. I won't go through this in detail, but really the big vision here is end-to-end integration for this entire process. So fleet owners in this space don't have one good tool to use to really run this operation. There's a lot of fragmentation. There's one tool for GPS and telematics. There's another for maintenance tracking. There's another for invoicing. We're really building out that process where all those things are one place and they talk to each other. We've already built out gig worker verification. So verifying that these drivers and the vehicles are in fact gig workers. We have a lot of other kind of adjacent products and tools that are coming out in the next year. We're raising right now, $3.5 million. That'll primarily be used to hire. We're going to be bringing on our first in-house engineering talent, CTR lead developer, sales and business development professionals to really manage and nurture the relationships with our fleet owners, and then digital marketers just to keep the funnel full on both sides for both drivers as well as fleet owners. $3.5 million investment gets us to 6 markets within the next year and $6 million in revenue. And with that, I will open it up for some questions.
Questions? Who has questions?
How do they get the car? Or are you just asking about the day in general? Yeah. So one thing I'll mention that I didn't mention in the pitch is that the drivers keep the vehicles for long periods of time. So they're not required to bring the car back or anything like that, which is different from some of our competitors. But general workday is usually broken up into different segments, right? So part of the benefit of gig work is that you can kind of manage your time. So a lot of our drivers, they'll get up in the morning, they'll take their kids to school, and then they'll work for a while, and then they have the freedom of flexibility because they don't have to be physically at an office or at a job to be able to go pick their kids up from school when they get out, and then they usually work again at night. So varies depending on the type of work you do, deliveries, rideshare, and otherwise, but that's, we generally see that schedule kind of broken up throughout the day. Yeah, 64 days on that is the average rental period. Yeah. Correct. So I'll jump back here quickly. Yeah, so the question was basically if the driver is able to make enough money after they pay the rent and the rent for the vehicle and then the take that Uber and Lyft takes. 96% of our drivers are still making more money than they were making previous to renting from Jack. So a lot of our drivers are what America would consider to be unskilled labor. So they may be working in retail jobs or fast food, et cetera, making about 10 to 12 bucks an hour. The average driver in Atlanta currently makes about 29 bucks per hour. So even after paying the rent, they're still able to take more money home than they were making previous to renting. That's cool. Yeah. Yeah, so the average rental price, the question was how much money do we make on a transaction? So the average rental price today is about 60 bucks. We take anywhere from 30 to 40%, depending on the deal that we have with the fleet owner. So on a $60 rental, Jax would take home about 24, and then a remainder would go to the fleet owner. Yeah, right. Donnie. Yeah, so prior to now, we actually started as a fleet owner. So we were essentially our own first customer. We built the platform, and we actually, sorry, the question was how are we gonna 6x revenue next year? We started as a fleet owner, so in addition to having the platform that connected the fleet owner with the driver, we actually owned a fleet of vehicles to start. And what we learned through that process is we had a very strong, profitable small business. But as we looked to scale, we needed to be able to grow the size of our fleet without having to have that initial cash outlay for buying vehicles, which is when we started to kind of onboard the fleet owner. So to answer your question directly, the way we 6X is by onboarding large fleets that have vehicle inventory that can service the demand. So our demand right now is we have 98% fleet utilization. So of the vehicles we have available at any given time, 98% of them are rented. To service that demand, we started to onboard our first large fleets. We have a deal that's launching in 2 weeks. I can't say the name yet, but it's a large dealer based here in Atlanta. They have 10 stores in the Southeast, 4,000 cars, and they've already committed $1 million worth of assets before the end of this year. So the way we 6X is just by leaning into those fleet relationships and onboarding more fleets onto the Jax platform. Yeah, so the question was how do we deal with maintenance, accidents, et cetera. Maintenance, we have a national network of mechanics that we use through a partnership with a company called Car Advise. It's the largest mechanics in the country, so think about Firestone, Tire Plus, Pep Boys, et cetera. Every driver within their app, the Jax app, they have a fleet card. They can go directly to those mechanics and they can get the routine maintenance done on the vehicles. That way they don't have to break up their rental or return a vehicle to get it maintained and stuff like that. Yeah. We got 16 seconds left. I think we can say one more. Yeah, so we have a master assurance policy with a large insurer. So basically, we're allowed to add our drivers or remove them on a daily basis. That insurance covers the vehicles when it's either between rentals or when it's off platform. So when we rent that vehicle, the second a driver turns on the Uber or Lyft app, Uber or Lyft insurance is the primary insurance. And then when they turn it off, if they're taking their kids to school, going to the doctor, et cetera, our insurance comes into play. That's about 30% of the time.
Yeah. And that was the question, was who carries the insurance? Thank you so much. Let's give it up for Jax Rideshare. All right, guys. I just want to say we have two down, three to go. Are you impressed with what you've seen so far? Do you see these people are walking amongst us in Atlanta? So if you know an entrepreneur, make sure that you refer them to us because they can come on the stage and there's always investors in the audience, investors that are watching online, and there's loads of opportunity. So we are so, not right now, but almost excited to present our next one. Oh. All right. Right now, coming to the stage, actually at the stage. We have My UTI. Let's give it up.
Hi, I'm Lindsay Williams, co-founder of My UTI, a modern woman's pelvic health testing company transforming urological and vaginal care through testing, starting with the $14 billion UTI market. Well, that's not gonna work. One moment.
Live demo.
All right, just kidding. Premature, but that's a different company. Okay, meet Anna, a 34-year-old woman who is a working mom and has UTI symptoms that started 6 months ago. She has had countless primary care visits. She has had 4 GYN visits, 2 urgent care visits, alongside multiple failed treatments. And unfortunately, her situation is not unique because UTI care in the United States is ineffective, episodic, and expensive. That's why we created My UTI, accessible on-demand ordering without the hurdle of insurance or an appointment, convenient at-home collection with proven evidence-based PCR testing for personalized results in 24 hours that lead to targeted treatment. How does that work? by not leaving your house. You can order your MyUTI test online, collect your sample in the comfort of your home, receive your results, and choose a care pathway that fits your needs. We currently offer two paths to purchase: a MyUTI complete kit for when you have an infection right now that's delivered fast, or a just-in-case kit for having on hand the next time you start to have symptoms. You can simply activate your test service online and send in your sample. We're addressing the UTI problem in a unique way. Our competitive advantages include being the first to market to bring a comprehensive test directly to consumers. We look at the top 12 symptom-causing pathogens for urinary tract infections in a single sample. We know our consumers, and by talking to them, we know there are many more of them out there. Anna represents just one of the 23 million sexually active females in the United States, women who are busy moms, professionals, and prioritizing convenience for their care. We also know Sonia, an actual MyUTI customer, who unfortunately, like millions of women, has infections so frequently that they're considered chronic. And Phoebe, who represents the 20 million women in menopause who suffer with urinary or vulvovaginal symptoms. This market matters because this is how it makes people feel. After ordering our test, Anna sent in an email that said, "I want to cry, honestly, of relief, because it has been 4 months in pain, 6 negative urine tests, providers who would not listen, gave me horrible diagnoses, and I just knew it was an effing UTI." UTIs are just the start of this serving this massive pelvic health testing market where women are seeking to control their care. Consumer at-home testing is a rapidly growing market and drives us to over $100 million in revenue by year 5, predominantly driven by DTC testing as well as strategic referral partner testing. We've already started to build out these strategic partnerships, establishing relationships with telehealth, as well as brand collaborations, filling the diagnostics care gap for telehealth, driving volume, all while lowering our customer acquisition cost and providing a cohesive consumer ecosystem. Since our launch, we've had strong organic month-over-month revenue growth, doubling nearly every month. We've been steadily building on our social networks, tapping into TikTok, Instagram, Facebook, etc. And our milestones to date have been focused on building a frictionless care platform. While future roadmap includes deeper integrations with telehealth and pharmacy, as well as menu expansions into crossover areas of women's pelvic health and retail placement. We're leveraging our status as industry veterans to execute on these initiatives, pulling from our deep experience in both diagnostics and infectious disease. And of course, backed by other industry leaders and experts. So we are seeking $2.5 million in seed funding to expand our market access, our menu, and double down on our consumer marketing efforts. Just because it's common doesn't mean it's normal. Join us as we modernize pelvic health testing for women with MyUTI. Questions?
Yes.
NGO, have we considered NGO partners? Yeah, it is actually something. So have we considered NGO partners? Yes, thank you. they give you extra points if you repeat the question. Actually, it is something that has come up. We have been predominantly cash-based because the hurdles that, unfortunately, health insurance present, right, both regulatorily and then just frankly from an access perspective. And it has been part of our conversation that actually at our price point of sub-$200, it's cheaper for many women to get access to our type of testing and telehealth with a price transparency than to go to an urgent care or an emergency room where literally billions of dollars in UTI care are spent every year in our healthcare system. Why women? Okay, so two reasons. clinically, if a male has a UTI, we won't get into all the reasons. I'm sure you all had in anatomy class. When men have a UTI, it is automatically considered complicated, which means it gets more attention and treatment. Also, men are much less likely statistically to get UTIs. 80% of women will have one UTI in their lifetime. 40% of those women will get them often. Two, women are the market in terms of driving online consumer testing and at-home health testing. We have had men order. I'm not going to lie. We have had men order. We won't stop you. Okay. Any other women have any questions? No, okay, let's go here. What portion of the tests come back positive? Okay, that's a great question. In our data, about 80% of them come back positive. Yes, and just because you have a negative test does not mean, especially if you have symptoms, that you don't need to be seen by a doctor. There's a lot of crossover activity of what symptoms present and what could be causing them. Yes. Okay, you had your hand up a long time ago. Philanthropic solution? Okay. At what point would we be able to provide a philanthropic solution to underserved communities? And I'm assuming globally? Yes. So there's a couple of hurdles with that. We are still lab-based. This is PCR testing. So the same like swab up the nose that you were sending off for COVID to a laboratory, it's the same type of testing that we do. So it does require a laboratory. So from a sample shipment perspective, depending on where all we could have laboratories located across the globe, would be somewhat dependent on that. We do love the idea in terms of, you know, being philanthropic. But we just launched 6 months ago, so we got to get over some hurdles with scale to be able to achieve those initiatives. Okay, yes.
So you have the testing piece. How do you connect that to treatment and getting women treatment?
How do we connect women to treatment? So this is actually great. We do not want to be telehealth. We feel like there are plenty of amazing telehealth platforms out there. We would like to be the connective tissue that solves the diagnostic gap for telehealth, which means we can partner strategically for dual integrations with telehealth companies. So when you call and it's your third appointment and your doctor's like, hey, I think we maybe need to look and see what's causing this infection to keep coming back, I'm going to send you my UTI kit. And then when I get those results, we're going to know exactly what to treat with you. Does that address your question? Yes, sir. Yes, retail for UTI testing is factored into our revenue. Yes. Yes, sir. All right, one last question. So actually we are, why just UTI? My UTI was the beginning, and we see opportunity for a lot of pelvic health testing because STIs as well as bacterial vaginosis, as well as other menopausal symptoms, all can create the same symptomology. So my UTI was a really available domain at the time. And it kind of started from there. But we do have plans much, much beyond, and we also own all the other domains. So let's give it up for my UTI.
Oh my God. Who's like touching their pelvis right now? Wait till you leave. No, just joking. I'm awful, y'all. I'm sorry. Okay. While he gets set up, I have one more. Actually, I have two more shirt giveaways. But let's see. Da, da, da. This one. Okay, Tiandris. That is what you are. We have a support entrepreneur. Thank you, Armada. We have a support entrepreneurs t-shirt. Who here is an entrepreneur? That was very aggressive. I think he should get that shirt. Now touch your pelvis. Take the shirt, touch your pelvis. Okay, I'm getting out of here now. Welcome to the stage, Vanessa Dex.
Hello, hello, Atlanta. So I'm Vladimir Shetnikov. I'm from Turkmenistan, and it's my first year officially since I've been to the U.S. And your guys are awesome. So I'm a co-founder, full-time stuff maker, and developer at Kinda Smart. So imagine this situation. So you got your knee injured, right? You go to the doctor, and then the doctor prescribes you a set of physiotherapy exercises. And unless you're willing to pay a lot of money on in-person physical sessions, you will be left with either having to work out at home or with the telemedicine. And by telemedicine, I mean the maximum you'll get is a Zoom session. And this is where kinesthetics comes. We noticed that there is a problem, and a lot of people do not have an opportunity to get reliable, real-time feedback on their movements. For instance, when they do physiotherapy or fitness. And this is exactly what we did. So I'm going to be doing live demo of the Fall app, which I did for Android and iOS. One moment, I'm going to be sharing my screen. Okay, phenomenal. Amazing. Okay, so once you register and complete a set of surveys questions, you will be able to see a recommended workout, which is tailored at your needs. So, for example, in my case, I want to strengthen my arms and shoulders. And when I click here, you're going to be able to see the description, what is included in the workout. You can select the training method, all good stuff, right? But the magic happens when you click the start button. When you click the start button, you will be asked to rest your phone against the wall to make about a 90-degree angle. And when we do that, we'll be asked to take about 3 to 4 steps back so that we can fit in the frame.
Stand about 3 to 4 meters away from your phone to fit in the frame.
One sec.
Make sure to stand in the right position.
And you'll be
just
getting
like
the real-time feedback all the time.
Please breathe in while lifting your hand up.
This is dangerous.
Make sure to raise your arms all the way up. Well done. Make
sure
to keep the form of your spine.
30 frames per second, or actually even faster depending on
your
device.
The code on your screen shows the correct
position
for this exercise.
You can also control the workout flow with gestures, so you don't have to go to the phone to go to the next exercise. So just use five gestures like this.
The code on your screen shows the correct position for this exercise. Make sure to follow her. Lift your elbow.
Oh, in a moment.
It is not time to rest.
Just like that. So you'll have to.
Make sure
you can also go to the previous exercise with a similar
screen for the best results.
You can even pause the workout and resume it with this gesture.
Pause activated. To resume the workout, cross your hands.
So the point is, when you complete the workout and you get all-time real feedback, you'll be presented with a lot of statistics which will show your total reps. But most interestingly, it will give you information on how many mistakes you've done. This information might not be interesting to you specifically, but it will be very interesting to your health instructor. And this is where we come to the health instructor dashboard. So during the registration, you'll have an option to select that you're a health instructor, and you'll be presented with this dashboard where you can easily invite your client. Once you do that, since I'm my own instructor and my own client, I can check my data, how many workouts I've done, how many repeats I've taken. And if you're not satisfied with our own workout selection, you can assign your own workouts. So you can select from all the variety of workouts we provide, let's say the same knee. You can customize it by increasing the time, rest duration and everything. Save it, assign it, preview. You can assign the reminder when the person needs to exercise. Click assign. Amazing. I go home. And I can instantly see the workout pop up here. So we offer three subscription plans. And each one starts at $20. And basically, the person who will be able to see the workout, they'll have all access to the workout, to the AI information. So basically, all the AI feedback will be the same as I've just shown. So it will show like exactly each step you need to do. Amazing. So any questions?
Who has some questions? We have one right over here.
Yep. So as of now, how many users do we have? So as of now, we have about 1,000 users. We just launched literally about in March 2022. And initially, our app was mostly fitness-based. So we had only, so basically all the workouts were only for fitness. And then we pivoted and we decided, okay, we need to go further. We need to make our solution B2B2C so that we can work directly with the physiotherapists and doctors so that we can provide them a platform where they can assign the workouts. So we've been working on that, and literally a month ago, we finished with the health instructor dashboard. We haven't done any marketing at all. And as of now, we're working with Aster and other hospital chains in UAE. Why UAE? Because it's the best playground for startups. It's the easiest one to get in. And we're projecting to have about 50,000 users in the next 6 months. Yeah, thank you. Yeah, but as of now, we have only 1,000 users. Yeah. Yep.
So when you were doing the presentation, which was great, by the way, it made me think of, if I take a out-of-body viewpoint of all the exercises that I do incorrectly in my home gym, it would be great if I could get told by someone how I should fix my form. Is that something that's on the table for this, or is it strictly focused on rehabilitation?
So the question was, if I understood it correctly, is the main focus of our app strictly focused on physiotherapy, or
so? Oh,
so is the question mostly based on what kind of workouts do we provide? So is it only physiotherapy and fitness, or are we planning to integrate more? Yeah, so exactly. We're planning to integrate dancing. Since this is completely real time and it works both on Android and iOS, we're planning to integrate even dancing classes and boxing classes as well. So this is not only physiotherapy and fitness. It is physiotherapy and fitness as of now, but we're planning to grow. Yeah, exactly. Sorry, EU? Sorry, what? Could you please? Variables? Oh, yeah, exactly. Well, I'm not really sure if we're planning to do that right now, but it's definitely an interesting point. We might consider it.
So the question was, are you looking at incorporating wearables? Just repeating the question.
Oh, incorporating wearables, yeah, exactly. We definitely need more data on how many calories a person burns, because this is technically only an estimation. How many calories a person has burned during an exercise. So gaining access from like Apple Watch would be absolutely awesome, and we're definitely working and looking forward into integrating that as well. Yeah, sorry. Yep, your question? The pricing model. So we offer 3 subscriptions. One is monthly. The second one is for 3 months, and then for 1 year. So it's annual. And the monthly subscription starts at $20 a month. So, yeah, another question? You?
Any insurance?
Yeah, exactly. So, it is an absolutely awesome question. So, we haven't planned. Yeah, the question was, are we planning, how are we monitoring if a person is safe out there during our exercises, as it was with me, I almost fell. So we're planning to integrate a survey after each exercise if a person needs to do so. For instance, if you have a severe injury or a severe case where you need to exercise intensively and you actually need like adjustments to your exercise, we'll be providing survey for after each exercise. And we could also do this with a gesture, like let's say if you have experienced any pain during an exercise, you might just do like this gesture and it will count as a yes. So we'll adjust according to that. So yeah, we're planning to take liability, but as of now, we're not offering that. Yeah, thank you, your question. Yeah, so the question is, which is the best model for user acquisition, if I understood correctly?
Yeah, which has the lower cost per acquisition? Is it the end user or the coach?
Yeah, exactly. So which is the lowest model to get user acquired? So basically, that is exactly why we pivoted to B2B2C model. So initially, our app was only fitness focused. However, once we did pivot, we decided, you know, we might not do any marketing at all. Once we go to an insurance provider, we offer them our app. If they jump in, basically we have a lot of doctors that will be basically providing the services of marketing for us for free. So I think that the health instructor model is definitely the lowest in terms of user acquisition. And including even user retention costs as well, because the doctor will be receiving feedback instantly. And if something happens, the doctor will take the responsibility for the patient and inform us directly. So it's like it's a very interesting model to work with. Yeah.
Let's give it up for Connect Sticks.
Thank you.
All right, we are here at the time of our final pitch. Make sure you stay. Because at the end, this will open up Slido.com. You'll use that code ATLSV88 to vote on who you think should go to the pitch off, but they will win this evening. And I say win, I mean everyone. All of these companies are so dynamic. So I'm so excited. You see, she's got tech stars over here on her computer. She's one of the most recent class. And without further ado, we have Palmly.
Hi, everybody. So I love a good story. That's how I'm going to start. About 11 years ago, it's not moving to the next. Oh, there you go. About 11 years ago, I moved here to Atlanta with just $300 in my pocket, hoping for a fresh start. I was alone, I was homeless, and I was unfulfilled. About 6 months later, however, my life completely changed after a group of people introduced themselves to me at a Chick-fil-A restaurant. And at that point, I found God, I found a new church, and I found community, people that I could learn and grow in faith with. But now, the church landscape has shifted, leaving places of worship to deal with attrition at an increasing rate, especially since the pandemic. And this $50 billion industry just cannot afford to rely on chance meetings at fast food restaurants to grow. My name is Rita Brooks, and I am the co-founder of Palmly, where people build community and get matched to a church that fits their unique needs and personalities. Essentially, we give churches an innovative way to bring more people into their doors, and here's how that works. So users visit our website, and they'll take about 4 minutes to create a profile and answer some questions to give us more insight into their unique circumstances and their desires. Then we match them to a church using factors like size, denomination, and more. So no more wasting time Googling, asking around, or visiting church after church. From there, we'll connect our user with a shepherd. Now, our shepherd is a liaison at the church that they're matched with. And during their visit, our user is greeted by their shepherd, they're shown around, and they may even be introduced to people along the way. Now, our users love this experience. We turn a process that can be really long, really tedious, and really frustrating, and we make it to one that is more seamless and enjoyable. Now, there are about 18.4 million Christian adults around the country that move each year and they struggle to find the right church. And then there's another 97 million Christian adults that are not moving, but they're looking for the right church and they hate the friction that's associated with it. Both of these people want a solution like Palmly, and we have the traction to prove it. During our recent time at the TechStars Atlanta Accelerator,
in partnership with Cox Enterprises, we wanted to test some of our assumptions, and so we set out to match 100 people to a church in 30 days. The demand was so overwhelming that we were able to match 500 people to a church in just 3 weeks. And not only that, but 71% of our visitors made our match their new church home, which is awesome. So with all this good that we're doing, you're probably wondering how we make money. Churches pay a subscription fee to be added to our database to receive potential matches, essentially gaining another marketing arm. There are 380,000 churches in the United States alone, and each year these churches are spending about $25 billion to attract new people into their church through traditional marketing channels. And then about 76% of them have no way of even tracking their marketing results, and so that presents a massive opportunity for us. Currently, the religious tech space consists of two lanes. So there is software to manage people, tasks, and money. And then there are apps for individuals that help them to improve on their daily faith habits, like a Glorify or a Halo. But Pomley is pioneering a new lane, one where we cultivate community building and we help bridge the gap between church and people. One of the things that we do is we help people get plugged into our online community where they're able to find, meet, and engage with other people exploring faith just like them. One of our learned secrets is that it's connection and community that are the keys to sustainability for a church and its members. And so that's why later phases of Pomley will include us licensing out our technology to these churches to help more effectively engage their congregations. So think engagement rooms, analytics, and even payment gateways to help these church leaders make better decisions and increase their impact. Now, you won't find a better team to fulfill this mission. We are former sales professionals, we are marketing executives, and we are community builders, and we have over 20-plus years combined ministry experience. But most importantly, we have experienced this problem firsthand. If you remember that Chick-fil-A story I told you at the beginning, not only did I find a church and community, but I also ended up finding my husband, and he's my co-founder. And so now we're on a mission. Thank you. We built a beautiful life together, honestly, and it all goes back to those 11 years ago. And now we're on a mission to give more people an outcome just like ours and just like some of the people that we've been able to match to our church. And we know it starts with the community right in the palm of their hand. So if you are an investor, we invite you to scan that QR code to follow up on our updates. And if you are interested in looking for a church on your own, then visit us at getpomley.com and we'll be happy to have you. Any questions?
Who has questions?
Yes, sir.
Okay, you're basically following the apartment finder model.
You can say that. You can say that.
So if I am not a church that is invested in you, mm-hmm. would you recommend me as a church for your client?
As it stands right now, we will. Oh, repeat the question. Thank you. If you are not a church who is on our platform, will we recommend you? Yes, we will. Ultimately, we want to find the best church for a person. So that's what it's all about. But we do, without going into too much detail, we give special attention to our churches who are signed up to better market to people who are more likely to be a good fit for that particular church. Yes, sir. That is another great question. So within the Christian...
Please repeat the question.
Will Pomley be extending into synagogues and probably other religions and things like that too as well? Right now, there are so many different denominations in Christianity. We're still figuring out all the things there are with that. It's definitely something that we have thought about because there will obviously be a need there as well. But there's just, it's later down the road. We don't know much about those. Yeah. yes, sir.
How do we make money?
So we make money from the church. The church is our customer. And so in order for them to get more visibility, in order for them to get like specialized people to be matched with their church, more likely to match with their church, then they're the ones who pay us the money to be added to our database to receive matches. So we're like a marketing, another form of marketing for their church, because what we do is we give them an opportunity for people to find out about them who would have otherwise never known about their church. I'm sorry?
Are you profitable right now?
Are we profitable right now? We're a startup. Yes, sir.
Mm-hmm.
He asked, how does a user get matched with the church? There was no swiping component. We thought about that actually at one point in time. But what we did was we surveyed like over 100 people and asked them what factors were important to them when they're looking for a church. And so there's a survey that one takes, and then there's other factors that we use as well to make our decision about, that goes into an algorithm about how we make our decisions to match people to a church. Yes, sir. So the subscription fee to be added to the database is $2,000 annually. And then there is also placement fees for every qualified person who becomes a long-term member of the church. Because you're now, you're getting people who are serving, who are tithing, and things like that. Yes, sir. Mm-hmm. That's a good question. He said, we have a community, so is there a way that churches can also push their events and things like that? So what I was saying earlier is that eventually we will license out our community features to these churches, because I talked about attrition at the beginning. So these churches are not only wanting to have people come into their doors, but they're also wanting a way for it to keep people there. And we know that connection and community is a huge part of that. If a person has friends and they're connected in the church, they're more likely to stay and be sticky in the church. And so there will be a way eventually for churches to advertise their events, to connect their congregation so that they can now chat and communicate within the app as well. So yes, that is for sure coming. Yes, sir. That's a great question as well. We want to
be
able to...
Can you repeat the question?
Yes. What is our exit strategy? Our exit strategy is to be able to IPO. There are a lot of companies who we see that we could also sell to as well. But if we can't, we plan to IPO. Yes, sir.
Yeah, I have a
That's another good question. He asks, how are our users finding us? And so we are in the process at the very end of having a really great SEO strategy that not many people are doing, especially in this industry. But right now we use micro-influencers, which we've gotten really great results from that. That's how we were able to do like 500 people in 3 weeks. So trusted micro-influencers is our main way of going about it right now. Can I take one? That's it? Sorry. Okay, meet with me after.
All right. Wow.
I mean, you guys are so smart. Seriously, all of you are so smart. All right, I am bringing my computer up to the stage. I am getting ready to open the poll. Hopefully I do not have any technical issues. Yes, I'm going to repeat what's at stake one more time. Okay, first of all, can I get this straight at the same time? You're going to do that? Okay, great. All right. So you're going to vote. One of these magnificent business owners will have the opportunity to participate in the pitch off this spring. Now, they'll be against other companies that have won the evening, and they will be able to pitch for an opportunity to get two hot desks and parking valued at $13,000. So start voting. Polls are open. Slido.com. That's Slido.com. Code ATLSV88. And we've got our Jeopardy music going.
And don't worry, in just a second, we're going to show you what the polls look like. We just want everybody to get a chance to see the URL.
Thanks, Buddy. That's really his name. It's Buddy. Just FYI. All right, get a little bit of this for social, some of this live action. Oh. Is that the... Okay. All right. 10,
9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Oh, crap. Congratulations, Jax Rideshare. Yay! Congratulations to Jax Rideshare. Thank you for everyone who participated. Thank you to everyone who came out and braved the weather and came during holiday season. We appreciate you. Our next one will be in February. I believe it's the 13th. That's off my memory. So, you know, make sure you check the same way that you came to get here tonight. I'm pretty sure it's the 13th. But thank you so much for coming. Network, connect, find a co-founder, find your CTO, find your investor.
Drink one more beer. Thanks, y'all.
Thank you. I don't